We are here on the black carpet for the world premiere of the new Warner Brothers movie, Rock of Ages. Several of your biggest stars are coming out tonight, guys like Tom Cruise. We have Julianne Hough coming, Alec Baldwin, some of your favorite rock bands of all time. Def Leppard is going to be joining us in just a little bit as we get ready to watch the black carpet heat up. These guys are heading inside Man's Chinese Theater for tonight's world premiere. I'm Mark Istook.
Oh, I'm Ricky Rackman.
There is an enormous amount of authenticity in terms of the behavior and all of that in the movie. You know, it's not a documentary, so this is a comedy, and it's musical, and it's from music all over the place, but it is nothing more than a party. Oh, God, it was heaven on earth. I mean, this was my time. This was the greatest.
It was so much fun. To me, I almost think that the process of making a movie is even more fun because I love the like how you get to perfect everything and like go in every single day and work at it. It's about being a dreamer and following your heart and being true to who you are. Of course, there's going to be mishaps along the way, but it's always kind of finding your way back.
With the character, there is that style of the 80s, but I was hoping to embody, you know, our own rock guy. Here's this guy who's kind of caught up in this world, yet still he's a rocker and he's a poet and sees himself in that way. And so there wasn't one specific person, but it was definitely inspired by all of them. It was so much fun. Come on, man. I have the best gig in the world. Like,
there's a lot of good music from the 80s. A lot of it's in this film.
This kind of music, when it was in its prime, I was listening to like the Smiths and the Cure and tinnitus. It's an ear condition where you hear this noise. But now that I've heard it in the context of this film, I enjoy this music enormously. I slept in those clothes, came directly to set, and even that wig I wear as a nightcap. It was one of the easiest jobs I've ever had to do.
I had 6 days to get my part nailed in this with my song, Hit Me With Your Best Shot, and a great duet I do with Russell Brand in it. And I had the best time. And when I saw the movie, not the final cut, I went, yes, I'm having as an audience member as much fun as I did making it. This was such a very specific time for this kind of music, right here on the strip. It just has such nostalgia.
You know, it's like we built this city on rock and roll, and that's like we built this movie, rock and roll. It was, when I saw this film, I could not stop moving. It was like you're bouncing, you're singing along, and then you catch yourself and they go, nah, it's okay. So I think everybody's going to have a great time.
Oh, the cruises, pour some sugar on me. That's the thing I like. That was amazing. Watching it filmed and then watching the movie, it's amazing. These are really nice people, and we had a really fun time. So it's nice to see all of them again.
Tonight, you know, I'm a little rock and roll hip-hop.
I like that.
I'm mixing both worlds because I come from, you know, that element as well.
My best memory from the 80s has got to be, I guess it was the clothes. But I remember my mom, and she had, like, the hot, like, high spandex pants that were in blue and, you know, the big old hair and the red nails. And I mean, those were some great outfits.
This movie just captures the era of when we started, you know, doing all those songs.
We saw the movie. It's great.
I am ready to rock. We're going to not only going to get to see the movie, which is going to be great, and but then a chance to go over and Poison and Def Leppard lay it down tonight right across. The after party's where it's always at.
Though I tried not to hurt you, girl, though I tried, come on, I guess that's why she cried. Every road has a song, I need to hear you, babe, come on. Just like every night has its dawn, oh, wow. Just like every cowboy sings a sad, says it's all right.